What's going on, gamers? Today we're going over how to connect to the forest with your Apex server. Before we get started, don't forget to like, subscribe, and ring that notification bell in order to stay updated on all of our future videos. The Forest is a hilariously fun survival game with tons of horror themes sprinkled in. I mean, you start out in a plane crash, all bloodied and beaten up. Of course, you have to scavenge, fight, and survive on this terrible island you've been trapped in, but after a while, you'll finally get to build some really awesome structures and a great base. But this is all done better when you have friends to play it with. So today, we're teaching you how to join a server to play with your friends. The first thing that we need to do is get a Steam token. So go ahead and head to this URL that's currently up on the page and log in with your Steam ID. From here, you're going to sign in, and once it is loaded, you're going to type in 242760 in the app ID section at the bottom. Of course, you'll add a memo, which will just be better to name things, and you'll call it the Forest, as that's what this token is for. Select create, and a big long stretch of numbers and letters will appear. That is your login, and it's absolutely crucial. So make sure you copy that once you have it set up. From here, you're gonna head to your Apex panel, of course, and then you're going to make sure that the server is stopped. In fact, it really shouldn't be running at all if you don't have the Steam token. So what you're gonna do is go to the left-hand side where you see customizations and select it. Then you're going to scroll down to where you see Steam Server Login Token, GSLT, and type in that big long stretch of numbers or copy-paste it. What you're gonna do from here is go back up to the top, and as you can see, it says changes to settings are automatically saved. So click the name of your server and start or restart the server to officially get it up and running. This may take a moment, especially if it's the first time that you've run the server. To join in-game, you're first going to want to click the multiplayer section, of course, and then you're going to select join game. From here, you'll see a list of different versions of joining, and you're going to select the dedicated internet version. Now, from here, you're going to filter by name and type in the name of the server. In this case, I just left it as the default, which is Apex Hosting Forest Server. Once that is typed in, you're going to select refresh, and after just a couple of moments, the first and only thing that should appear, because it is a unique name, is Apex Hosting Forest Server. From here, you're going to enter it and enter in the password that is in there, whatever it may be for you, and you're going to then select join. If it works properly, you'll see the loading screen, and just a few moments after that, you'll see the game start. Joining from Steam is a bit more difficult. The first thing that you're going to need to do is select the View button in the top left of your Steam browser and select Servers. From here, you're going to go to the Favorites tab in this new pop-up. Then you'll select Add a Server in the bottom right. In the new pop-up, you're going to type in your IP address from your server, port and all, and you're going to select Add to Favorites. Then you should be able to join no problem. Of course, if there's a password, you will need to add the password. But then just select Connect and the same thing should happen. The game will load and you'll be starting a new world. Now let's cover a couple of common issues, shall we? The first is if you can't find the server. What I recommend is making sure that you are in the correct section, in this case, the dedicated internet section, as, for example, peer-to-peer won't work, but if you type in the filter by name for dedicated internet, then it should show up no problem. Next is if the server is not online through Steam. This happens if the server panel is not online. It'll appear like it might be able to connect, but it won't. So just make sure that the panel is fully started and online, and everything should work out no problem. That is all you need to know, gamers. This is how you connect to a server. This is a relatively simple process, but if you're unaware of what you're looking for or have never done this before, it can be confusing. So hopefully this tutorial helped you out. Now it's all up to you to get started on building an awesome server with your friends. Go out there and find the lore if you want, or if you're like me, just launch a catapult for fun. That'll just about do it for this one, gamers. As always, I hope that you have lots of fun.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.